as the metaphor. So I ordered a sweet shop bell and stuck it on the lab, the laboratory door in the dark. I thought, this is going to be brilliant. Every time you open the door, you're going to hear that ding-a-ling-a-ling noise, and you're going to be just full of excitement, springing your step, just creative process, going ballistic, brilliant. Well, by halfway through the first day, the bell got ripped off the door, because the door was opening and shutting all day long, and it got really fed up with it. So that idea kind of got ditched. And another clip. Was a quite literal image of snail porridge. I think it's just when this worst went on the menu. There's another one here which we've got, which is hot and iced tea. So this one is where. Where we serve a black tea that's split in the middle, and half of it is hot and the other half is cold. And then the final one was coconut tobacco. Now, you guys in Spain probably don't know this, but there was a classic sweet we had as a kid called coconut baki, and it was crystallized coconut which was served in a little pouch so it looked like tobacco. So we basically made our own. So, this is all very well. I got really excited about it because I realised I could use this whole system to plant all sorts of pettifer, and I'll talk you through it now. So the first thing we do is temper chocolate, and we temper the chocolate overnight in sous vide bags because you get the crystals lined up more, and then go through the tempering process. This just a little bit of oil in the liner. We make a jelly from mandarin, and then take that on another tray. We fill the same molds, but with no jelly in, with the tempered chocolate. Scrape excess off, and then tip it upside down. So what we're doing here is creating a really fine shell. Nobody's eating, are they? So tapping out the excess chocolate, and then let that set. And then in the bottom of each one, we put the mandarin jellies. So then, next stage is to scrape off the excess chocolate. Made some tarts, and there's a classic little pastry in Britain called a jam tart. So I wanted to use the Queen of Hearts, which is a plain card, and some jam, get the jam tart flavour in. And then get that reference to Alice as well. So with this one, you've got a base of white chocolate. So the same thing, tempered in a water bath. And then here we make, it's basically a jam, it's a raspberry jam. more of a jelly that's then pureed. It's a fluid gel. So we'll set the jam into the jelly, but then break it up. So you just get a cleaner texture, cleaner mouthfeel. Again, just spray some lightly oil. These sheets we've had made, designed and made for us. And then the playing card transfers onto the mould, they're magnetic. So there's the Queen of Hearts. And then the white chocolate goes onto the moulds. And then just scrape the excess off. And you basically do that on both sides of the moulds. But on one mould, we have an extra, on the side, we have an extra frame, because I need to build a recess somewhere where we can fill these playing cards. So they're left to set. You can see they've got a ridge, look, frame, a ridge now. So here we've had this nozzle piping bag made to fit the width of the cards. And then the raspberry fluid gel gets piped in, and then inside of there we have a very, very thin sheet of shortbread pastry. And then you do the same with the other side. Just trim those off, and then we put these parts in a little envelope. Which we then seal with white chocolate that we colour with beetroot. And then for the seal, just get the wax stamp, the fat duck stamp. Just give it a quick dip in some liquid hydrogen. Now hang on a second. I knew it. Who's been spraying? Somebody's been spraying the smells of it. Minty tobacco, if I leave it for 2 months. So it takes on all the tobacco aroma. So it tastes of the smell of pipe tobacco. And then this is something we've been serving for quite a while now.
Anything you want to do it.
Sounds and the smells, and the whole thing just is there to conjure up imagination and excitement, the excitement of feeling like a kid in a sweet shop. So thank you very much.